Ahoy, friends. Welcome to Building the Alpha Dory. I'm Dan, and this is a project to build a Chamberlain-style racing dory from John Gardner's The Dory Book, illustrations by Sam Manning. Today we'll be out in the shop, and we're hoping to get the port side frames cut to the correct angle to receive the shear strake. And yeah, who knows, maybe we'll even get around to planing the planking a bit. Anyway, let's get out there before it gets too chilly out in the shop. Looks like another cool evening out here. Thankfully, I've got a little bit of a warm cuppa to keep me going. Ooh, it looks like maybe, oh yes, a little cracker with some port wine and cheese on it. And some of that hop mulled cider. Okay, so what we're going to be doing is using the beveling square and probably the steel to take the bevel angle of the of each of the frames, and then we'll go ahead and transfer those directly to the other side of the boat in a sort of seamlessly efficient process. So it says here that I'll just get a good matching bevel for either side of the hull. And just like we did with the other side, will be gonna go ahead and use the steel to sort of determine where the plank is falling. So where the steel hits the plank below it, that kind of gives me an indication where the plank will eventually, where the shear plank will eventually intersect the plank below it. So that kind of clues me in as to how wide of an edge I'm going to be leaving along this top edge. What I don't want to do is have either a feather edge here, too wide of an edge, which won't give me a good landing on the plank, because I want to be able to shave about an inch to an inch and a quarter off this plank of width to for the overlap to rivet through. And of course I don't want a feather edge, so I don't want less than a feather edge either. Like, I don't want to be planing back into this plank, because then you get unfair curve. So that's kind of what I'm eyeballing when I put the steel on here, how far into the frame I want to cut this bevel. And I'm just using the plank below it as a sort of fair curvature here to figure out how far over I want to cut that planking. Got some sawdust building up here. I gotta run that over to my field for a friend's chicken coop. Keep his chickens warm this winter. And it's about that time of the build where we're actually able to remove these Diagon Alley braces that are holding the frames out and into position while we were bending the planking on. So here's the next one anyway. And I'm throwing the steel on here and I'm using the beveled square to eyeball the angle I want. And, you know, as long as it's within a couple degrees, it's plenty close. So I'm not... definitely not overthinking it, but, taking my time to make the marks. So, so the other thing I'm keeping in mind when I'm making these marks is I'm right-handed, so I will be cutting, sawing with my right hand. So I'm making these marks on that side of the that side of the saw that's comfortable for me to saw on, so I'll be able to see the marks while I'm sawing. If I made them on this side, I'd be trying to saw like this.
to these.
Number 2, 3, and 4 frames have been pretty close, like within a degree or two from the same angle. I guess that shouldn't have been too surprising, but just a little bit interested. Looking pretty good. So I got the 4 frames marked pretty well. Alright, so that's the 4 frames marked. Now let's see what we can't do about getting a halfway decent line on the transom. So I can see when I put this steel on here that the line I just drew from the other side is quite good, because this is the angle of that gain. So that will mean that the plank will come down the transom and then lie flush on that gain. So that looks good right there. What I can do is I'll measure up a given distance, strike a line with the square, now I can measure over, make sure that I've got a similar width on either side of the center of the transom so that I'll know both those angles come into about the same spot. Yeah, might as well do that right now and make sure. Okay, so there's the line that I just drew with the T-square.
So that goes across perpendicular to the center line of the transom. Let's see how close we are. Five and three quarters. Five and 5/8 actually. Five. And strong of a half, about a 5 7/16, so almost 5 5/8, so pretty close. Yeah, very close, about a 1/16 off. So that's not bad. That's good. Yeah. And like I say, it's parallel flush, smooth to the plank game. So the plank that we put on there will sit flush to the transom and then smoothly transition over the board below it, lap over the board below it. So yeah, that's a good angle. And now we can start cutting some of these. But before we get to cutting, let's get a little warm up here. Oh, that was good. Now I'll better throw a little bit more fuel on the fire as well, just to keep things chugging along while we're in the shop working. Last thing we want is the fire to go out while we're out here. get things chugging along, and then we'll close it back up. And chugging in there now. All right, so let's get back to it. Thank you.
the number one frame. Looks good. I eyeball the line of the saw, the cut along the line of the planking, and just follow the line down the frame that we drew with the bevel square. So it's pretty straightforward. Thanks so much for stopping by building the Alpha Dory. Hopefully you'll get to tune in next time when we finish cutting those shear plank bevels into the frames. Until then, a massive thank you to everyone who's supported the channel with your likes, comments, questions, critiques, and subscribes. And just a massive thank you, and this channel wouldn't be possible without your support. So thank you much, and we'll see you next video. Have a good day. Bye.